Before I conclude my interviews, each of my guests get the same final question. What knowledge, information, or piece of advice would you offer to anyone who might be listening right now? What they share does not have to be related to any of the topics we discussed during the interview. It's not a rehearsed question, and the guest is given no prior notification that the question is coming, in the hopes that whatever they share is genuine and from the heart. Here are a few valuable pieces of wisdom from early This Way Out interviews.
One thing that you would like to share with somebody, what would it be?
I guess this would fall into that. Yeah. Because the one thing I would share is that everything happens for a reason. But sometimes it is very hard to see, understand why it's happening until well after. Mm-hmm. Because when I was getting out, when I got my retirement put on the plate, because mine was early, mm-hmm. 5 years early. When it was put on the plate, I'm like, how is this happening to me? Why is this happening to me? And now I look at it, I'm like, man, I am so glad it happened when it did. Because it took me those couple years to figure things out and be, or that.
You needed that time.
I needed that time. But now I am so happy on where I'm headed on my mm-hmm. path. And now I understand why I got out early. Yeah. Because I think if I had stayed in for another 5 years, yeah. I mean, don't think that it would have changed my thinking for a negative, but I may not have been so enthusiastic about
right.
where I'm headed now.
Right.
Because it took me a while to change right. completely change my direction on my future, on my career.
Yep.
So everything happens for a reason. It'll just be a while until you figure out
and
why.
And you seem to be in a very good place right now, dude.
The key to remember if you're thinking your life is bad comes from the prayer of the citadel that I remember from having been a nub at the citadel and having to be able to spit it out at any upper class requesting it.
Okay, so
part of it is, says, stand forever, yielding never to our tyrant's helm. Keep setting goals, keep reaching them, and as soon as you reach it, set a new one to go after and don't stop.
And that's what you've been doing.
Yes.
You haven't let a brain aneurysm, you haven't let physical disabilities stop you, buddy. I'm in awe of you, Tate. And I'm glad to know you, bud. I'd like to shake your hand if I could. Thanks. And thank you for your service, by the way.
Nobody is an exception to life. And some of us experience it differently and in difficult ways, just like Mr. Morris here, Matthew, sorry. It's fine. Just like Matthew here. But if Matthew can manage to find his way out, then I think it's possible for anybody to do it. So,
and everybody can. Just know that you are important. You are special. You are loved. Do not hold yourself to a standard that other people hold you to. Break the mold. Be your own person. It's not about what everybody else plans for you. It's about what you plan for yourself. It's about finding that purpose in life. Because once you have that purpose, everything will fall in line. It'll all fall into place. Just know that you're loved and you're special, just the way you are.
I couldn't have said it better myself, bro.
So that encouraged me to let me know that if he's the pastor, he's been the pastor of this church, this year will be 20 years. Mm-hmm. And so if him being the pastor for 20 years and he's still struggling with his past, mm-hmm. then that encouraged me. Mm-hmm. You know, because as long as we're in the flesh, we're still going to have worldly thoughts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, but like I said earlier, God gives us free will. And he gave us that so that we can come to him willingly. He's not going to make us. You know, and so anybody who's going through something, it ain't going to hurt to try.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's true. That's true.
If you don't get nothing, you're right where you've been.
Yeah.
You don't lose nothing.
Yeah.
But if you do get something, think of where you can go.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
an opportunity to say, put the last word in here. I always like to, you know, I tell people, you know, you've got an audience, an opportunity. And if there was one thing that you had to say to an audience, what would that be? An advice, whatever. The floor is yours.
I will sum it up in two pieces. The first one comes from Miss Frizzle on the Magic School Bus and the advice that misses every adult that watches it with their kids. In every episode, she's talking about life is about getting messy and making mistakes. But nothing about society in 2019 conditions us to get messy and make mistakes with our life. It's all about picture-perfect Facebook profile and Instagram profile. Get messy and make mistakes. And as a dad, control is an illusion. Let go of the control. Lean into your kids. Get messy. Make mistakes. Do something crazy. Have adventures. That control isn't something that actually exists in your family. And when you're trying to control it, it's just going to create more anxiety. Let it go. Be dad. There's something in the podcast I always remind every dad that kids spell love, T-I-M-E, that on your worst day, all they want is your time and attention. And as long as you're there and present in that time that you're there, it's not about the time you spend with your kids, it's the quality of time when you do spend it. Just focus on that. It's not that complicated to be dad, that just focus on that they spell love, T-I-M-E.
Opportunity and audience. And if there was that one thing that you felt you needed to share with someone, what would that one thing be?
It's going to be a cluster of one thing.
Sure, sure, sure.
And it's great that you say that. You know, we have to reinvent ourselves a lot when things, like you say, when things like this happen. So you have to love yourself. You have to love others. You have to be compassionate, but you have to remember to run your own race. So whatever cycle you fall into your process, you have to learn how to be delivered, cleanse yourself, right? Mm-hmm. You have to also embrace the process, mm-hmm. but then you also have to restore yourself. So that's why I say run your own race, because someone's always going to be doing something that we want to do, think we need to do. But as long as you're focused on loving yourself, everything else around you will be okay.
Yeah.
So that's my advice.
I like that. I couldn't agree more.